Yes, you heard it right. Less is more. Does that spark any questions in your mind? How less can be more? I'll prove it today. Have you ever heard people say that you can make 36 hours out of the 24 hours that you have in hand? Or have you ever realized that in our house or at any place or our workplace, we utilize only 20% of the space for 80% of the lifetime that we spend there? Or it's only 20% of the wardrobe that you utilize each day or in your lifetime, and you're most comfortable with those 20% of your clothes for 80% of your lifetime? I think most of us can correlate to it, right? But this 80-20 ratio is not just in wardrobe, in your lifetime, in your workspace. It goes on everywhere. Starting from businesses, entrepreneurship, quality problems, issues, software bugs, and this 80-20 ratio can be seen all across the globe. Now, what is this 80-20 ratio I'm talking about? This 80-20 ratio is nothing else but the Pareto principle, how it is commonly known today. Pareto, an economist from Italy, one finding noticed that 80% of the peas produced from his garden were produced only from 20% of the plants that were grown there. Then, being an economist, he started thinking that if this is the case with the peas, then this would definitely be the case with other things also. And being an economist, he applied this thing to study the wealth distribution in Italy. With his studies, he found that only 20% of the population was the one which held 80% of the wealth in Italy. And this is the case even today across the globe, that 20% of the billionaires, millionaires, and the tycoons hold 80% of the wealth of the world. Isn't that right? No. Yes. This 80-20 goes on from wealth distribution to other aspects as well. In 1940, Dr. Jurian, a quality management thinker, started applying this 80-20 rule to quality problems. He found that if still 20% of the problems found in any product or any software that cause 80% of the issues reported, be it in cars, be it in softwares, be it even in your mobiles, it goes each and everywhere. So, this 80% and 20% distribution meant that 80% of the decisions are taken in 20% of the meeting time. This 80% of interruptions are caused by 20% people. This we can even notice in our Toastmasters meetings, that at times we really don't begin our meetings 80% of the time because 20% people haven't turned up. Then 80% quality issues are reported from the 20% reported failures. 80% businesses are done by 20% of the sales force. 80% revenue is generated by 20% of the product range of any organization. And 80% results are generated from 20% of the activities that you do. So this 80-20 goes a long, long way. Now, with this 80-20, how does it affect our daily life? Do you know, this 80-20 principle, I myself have experienced. I was just thinking while researching this topic, and I noticed that being in Udaipur since so many years, I have just driven over 20% of the roads in Udaipur in 80% of the lifetime that I have lived till date. Then, this, even when I work at my workplace, 20% of the times I'm reports from the regional managers about the sales that are going to be done. And 80% of the time, I'm actually just communicating it to people around, giving them the numbers. The effective work that we do is just 20%, which is actually responsible for the income that we get. For the professionals here, the income that we get is only from the 20% of the work that we do, and 80% of the work, 80% of the time that we do is spent on activities which really don't matter to the organization. Now, putting this 80-20 rule to your life, how you can make more out of this less? It's all about priorities. If we actually prioritize all our activities in each day that we do, or in each week, in each month that we do, we can identify the top two activities that are most contributing to any outcome that we wish for. It could be a passion like cooking, it could be a passion like music, it could be anything, but you need to start working smart. And as we talk about passions, first we need to discover what is a passion. And for identifying that passion, many people say that cooking is my passion, like I said, or music is my passion, like maybe Aniket can say that. But passion is not just something that we consume from someone else. Eating out at a restaurant, listening to music is not passion. Passion is when you start generating output for other people to consume. Maybe by opening up a restaurant, maybe by becoming a music blogger. And this 80-20 rule can help be applied to all the aspects of life, from nutrition, relationships, social media, decision making, business, problem solving, matching subscriptions, your mobile app,